Hi, this is Eva Fly Movies, and we are at Thermik 2018 in Stuttgart. We're going to find out for you what's new here on the market, talk to vendors, see what kind of paragliders, harnesses and instruments we can expect for the upcoming flying season. The concept of the exhibition has changed a little bit. It is now a huge one. They merged the Thermik with the CMT and they are expecting some 250,000 visitors. So let's step inside and see what the vendors are willing to talk about. Maybe reveal some secrets and what's up on the roadmaps for us. Okay, we are at SciRide booth this year 2018 at Messe Thermik in Stuttgart. And what is really new that we can see here?
This year we are now releasing the SIS Evolution. So the SIS Evolution, we made it last year, and now we are finalizing the last features of the SIS Evolution. So this instrument is all new because it has it uses e-ink display. So it's a new technology of display which is highly readable. It's like Kobo e-readers. So you can see it easily in the sun when it's very sunny.
The biggest is like this. And the smallest.
And it's also a widescreen because it's a 6-inch screen, so you can see a lot of information. You can have big numbers, big screens, so it's easy to see, easy to catch information.
And what kind of pilot you think would be using this kind of instrument?
Yeah, we have competition pilots like Antoine Girard, which is running for the X-Alps, which is using it, and he's helping us improving competition features. And you can also new pilots can use it because you can customize the screens. So you can place only very basic informations like speed, altitude and value for the beginners. And when you are improving yourself in paragliding, you can have more precise and more helpful for the thermic, for the thermals,
yes.
And for navigation, for waypoints and competitions.
What about the battery lifetime? I think it's important if you have a long day that also your Vario keeps up with a long hours of working, yeah?
It mostly depends on what features you are displaying, because we have very high-end applications like 3D view, which is quite high consuming in the power, so it's reducing battery life. But you can expect to have 20 to 30 hours of battery life, so it's enough for flying in several days. The instrument also has a weather station, so you can use it at home and place it on your table, and it will show you the weather for the next coming days, and it will update every day, every hours, with our internet, with Wi-Fi connection.
So with other systems, you usually need something else to have it running, right? With the Kobo, you have external GPS, for example, I think. With the Kobo, you have external GPS device, for example, so that they have to communicate. Some people need extra batteries. Do you need anything else but this instrument?
No, there's nothing needed for the instrument. Everything is included, so you have nothing. Nothing else to bring, you just have the instrument and you have GPS, Wi-Fi, Bluetooth, everything is included here.
Last question, availability.
We have a lot of orders. If you want it this year, you have to order now.
Very good advice, thank you.
Hello. I start. So my name is Martin Schwarz. I'm the new guy at Super. We founded a new company in Germany. It's called Super Gradient GmbH. And this company is responsible for doing the distribution and to care about the dealers and schools in future for both brands, Gradient and Super. And And SubAir bought Gradient last year in spring 2017. But just to clarify, we will have two separated brands in future. So Gradient will remain an own brand and SubAir will remain an own brand with two separated R&D teams. So André Dupal is still designing the gliders for Gradient and Pierre-Yves is designing the gliders for SubAir.
We are now at SubAir booth looking at the new products, and I understand there are two new products, and we start with the new tandem harness.
Yes, we are with the new harnesses Minimax. This is for the passengers, and this is a really simple harness with a mousse bag inside, a very, very big protection for the hard landing, launching, and we are the both Minimax 2 and Evasion 2. This is the same. Here it is, I can show you the... So this is the Evasion 2 with the tandem rescue here. This is a complete set for tandem pilots. We want the best protection now. This is not so heavy. If you want a lighter product, you can always choose the airbag system. But now, for different markets, it's interesting to test with the bumper. And I think this is very simple product, so you have to test it. I can show you as well the new product. This is the Evo Light. Here we are with a new product in SubAir range harnesses. The name is Evo Light. You can see it. This is the natural evolutions from the Evo XC3. With the same protection, with the same combination, simple harness for progression, but with lighter, this is lighter, this is a lighter harness. We are around 3.6 kilos, so it's quite light for a harness with a big protection. Now we are using a new system, new buckle system here. Can show you the details of the buckles. This is like we use in other harnesses, but the Evo XC3 was with a different system. Now we use this one. This is the same as the Pixair one, just over there. And for the good protection and the light harnesses, this is a very simple and very easy harness to use, very comfortable. You can adapt the seat plates as well, and I think that's all. Nothing more, you have to use it, you have to test it, and you will have a good product.
Where can we test the SubAir products in Germany?
If you want to find the SubAir products in Germany, you can find on SubAir.com. Go on SubAir.com and find your resellers to test and buy a product.
So now I'm here with Peter from Jin, and we're looking at the new highlights of the year from Jin gliders. Peter, what's new on the market from Jin?
New on the market is we have some new harnesses, and for sure a brand new paraglider, like the beginner paraglider, the Bolero. And not very new, but I think this is the top season for this glider, is the Explorer, a kind of cross-country glider, light and all-around perfect glider.
What's the rating of the Explorer?
Explorer is in the high B class. And another some new products, little things like we have a concertina compress bag, and we have new speed gliders, but this is for the winter time especially. And coming soon is the new Yeti glider. This is the light weight glider. Everybody knows the Yeti. This is the mountaineering glider itself. And the new one is a perfect LiDAR. I know I tested a prototype, and we will see this soon. And the tandem glider is coming soon. And some performance glider, but step by step. A Class C glider called Gitio 2 is coming, but I think we wait 1 or 2 months because it should be perfect product.
And looking at what is available now, so if we look maybe at the harnesses, you have a lot of harnesses showing here at the booth at Thermic Messe 2018. What's your highlights in terms of harnesses at this time?
Yeah, the harnesses highlights, we have 3 fitting to the Yeti harness. And for sure we have there some different versions with airbag, without, a super light version. And then for standard paragliding, I call it like this, for beginners, 2 thermic flyers, they fly 5 hours. They can fly very nice the Gingo Airlite, Gingo Airlite 3. This is a perfect all-around harness with very nice features and very good comfort and safety. And then we have the race harness. This is brand new. I saw this 2 days ago.
So this is the Genie Race 4 we are talking about, right?
Yeah, this is the Genie Race 4. This is for competition. Everybody knows this. And this looks very funny, like Vespa with a glass shield.
It's like a windscreen that protects the pilot. Yeah. Peter, any other highlights of the year you want to share with us?
Yeah, a personal highlight for me is the Griffin. I like this mini wing very much because it has a big possibilities what you can do with this. You can fly in a holiday with very strong wind on the coast, or extreme mountaineering, or even light persons can fly this very easy, like nearly like a school gliders. And the performance is much better than most other mini wings, and safety same. This is a really nice glider. Everybody who like try a mini wing should fly with the Griffin.
Hello, I'm Aljaš. I'm coming from 777 Gliders from Slovenia. And for 2018, we have actually 3 models which will be on the market. So first is the Knight. It's a middle B class wing with 50 cells and quite performance for this class. And the focus on this wing was to build easy user friendly wing for a big range of pilots, but with a maximum performance output. And the wing really excels in climbing and also in the gliding. I think it's really good in this class, and it's really friendly to use and super stable. So when flying high speed and this with accelerator, the wing is super compact and easy to control. Then with the Knight, we have also lightweight edition. Its name is Keylight. And it comes fully from 27 Porsche material. And also we build a special Dyneema webbing risers, which brings total weight down to 1,200 grams compared with the classic Knight version wing. Also on the lightweight riser we are using soft leaks, so we also extra reduce the weight instead of classic carabiners hooking. The wing, the rest by design and all is similar to Knight, but it's 1 kilo 20 grams lighter. So it's special design for hike and fly and walking and maybe longer flights when you land and you need to come back by foot, so it's really much better for this one. And then the really new product is the Queen 2. We launched it this season, so 2018 model, yeah. And it's completely new built, new based. It has 73 cells. The first feedback from the pilots that it's really performance and easy to fly. So I think this wing will make quite good and happy pilots in the C category. It's a new design, new airfoil with special supports inside, with a special baton inside, which distribute the loads and makes really super compact canopy. And also the airfoil is optimized to have really good climb. So the glider really excels in climb, in the climbs, in thermals and this. It's really easy to out thermal the others with this wing. So this, and also for the C-class category, we have really high top speed. When we're using accelerator, the wing goes quite close to 60 per hour. So for the C-class, I think it's super fast. Okay, this. And also what will follow with the Queen is built in four sizes, but right after that will follow the Q-Lite. Q-Lite is the same lightweight edition of the Queen. It will be launched also this year and will also reduce again the weight down per kilo, kilo and a half almost. So we again fully lightweight Porsche 27 with a lightweight Dyneema razors and soft links. So with this wing we are targeting to the pilots who are flying cross country but need to walk to some takeoffs, and they can get really light package out and still really good performance. So basically this is all what we put out, and yeah, that's all from us, yeah. Thanks.
So now we are at the swing booth, and Lars is showing us their unique RAST system. It's a special system to manage the air within a wing. Lars, what is so special about the RAST system, and how did you come up with the idea initially?
At the very beginning, the idea was to improve the launching behavior of low-level gliders. The idea was to participate the canopy into two sections, in the front section and in the rear section, and it is participated by a wall inside. So that means the inflating or incoming air is blowing up the profile in front much faster than in the rear. And that is the reason why at launch the glider will come up very soon and quickly, and the rear part will fill with air more slowly, and this prevents the pilot from in result you will get a very very harmonious launching characteristic of the canopy. And that was the idea at the beginning, and when testing the new system we realized that the RAST system has more advantages than just the launching behavior.
So now you have it a little bit of time in the market. What is the first feedback from the pilots that really can see and feel it alive?
So honestly, I can say that all the feedback we are getting from pilots flying gliders with the RAST system, they are really, really happy, and we have only positive feedback. So up to now, nobody gave negative feedback on a RAST glider so far. The main thing is lots of pilots are talking about safety issues with the RAST system. This is what we are doing as well. Even more important is the RAST feeling you get, because you have a glider which is much more stable than gliders without RAST, and much more easier to control than gliders without RAST. And this is what everybody can feel flying a RAST glider, also if he is doing collapses or not, you can feel a difference.
Yeah, Lars, you just said it, you can feel the difference in the collapses. So does it also automatically mean it brings more passive safety for the pilot?
In our point of view, yes. But it's hard to give a proof on this, because Yeah, there is no standard turbulence you can fly through to give a real proof for the kind of working. The people are used to read the test reports from the EN tests and also the test reports from the DHV, an example safety class, and they are trying to they expect to have a better result in such tests. But this is something what you cannot see from the test, because it's the result, the RUST system, the advantage in regards to passive safety is not to make better results from the test reports, but it's a prevention system, and we are trying to take influence on the shape and on the size of the collapses, so that to keep the pilots away from really dangerous situations. And this is something you can only feel under real conditions.
And Lars, where will you be going in the future with this? Is there any further development planned? What could be ideas for the next iteration of the RUST system?
Yeah, the RUST system is offering lots of different possibilities, and we are at the very beginning. So at the moment, we think we have a very well working system, and we have to get the new technology through the certification procedure, homologation. And so we are limited at the moment, as long as the testing procedure is focused on the collapses, on the size of the and the reactions on those collapses. And as long as it doesn't matter whether the glider is more stable or not, or whether the glider might prevent, it's not taking into account preventional systems. So this is the difficulty at the moment. So with the NIOS, with the new NIOS RS, we have a RUST with valves inside. So we are trying, we have a sample here, and if you try, it's just the inflation from a ventilator, and you see that if you pull on the rear, it's not possible to get the air out the rear section. But in the front, it's easy. So you can see, oh, damaged. So you can see it. And with those valves, we are at the very limit, at the limit regarding testing procedure, because the test pilots from the testing bodies, they couldn't make such a collapse they need for the certification. And if we do it even stronger, it's impossible to make such a collapse being necessary for homologation. And that's the problem at the moment. But we are working on this, of course. And in the future, we'd like to have the RUST system inside all our different models, even in high-performance gliders, of course.
And what is the current names of the gliders you sell with the RUST system?
So at the moment, we are ready for sale with the Mito. It was the first glider with RUST.
What is this for kind of a classification?
It's an ENA glider, suitable for training. The second glider was the Twin RS, I think, Tandem. And then we launched the Arcus RS. It's a low B glider, and we have very, very positive feedback for this glider. And now we have the NIOS RS, and regarding performance, we are competitive with the high-end EMB gliders in this category. And then we have more gliders, not so popular, very popular like the Apus. It's some kind of a mini wing, depending on the wing load, and our speed riders, of course, with the RUST system inside.
Okay, Lars, thank you very much.
You're welcome.